This is a presentation on T-accounts and calculating account balances. A T-account is made up of a T, which is where it gets its name. It has an account name on top, dollar amounts that affect the account, and an account balance. The dollar amounts that affect the account may be a beginning balance, a transaction, or even an adjustment that the accountant made. An accountant will manually draw up a T-account to analyze an account. For example, an accountant may look at the transactions that affect telephone expenses and want to come up with a balance. Or the accountant may know the balance of a prepaid expense account and want to come up with an adjustment. It depends on what the accountant is analyzing. T-accounts are much less formal than what you will find in a general ledger, such as this that you might see with today's accounting software. Let's back up for a second. Some of you may not know what an account is. Some examples of accounts are cash, sales, and rent expense. Most of you probably already know what an account is, but if you don't, check your accounting textbook or see my video on accounts. Also, debits are posted to the left of the account and credits are posted to the right of the account. Most of you probably already know what debits and credits are, but if you don't, you can see my video on debits and credits. Let's look at a T account for cash. We may have $100 as a beginning balance in a cash account. We may have received another $10, and we may have sent out a check for $50. Now we want to know what our balance is. In this case, we would add up the debits and credits. The debits come out to $110, and the credits are easy. There's only one for $50. The difference is $60, which is posted to the left of the account because the debits are greater than the credits. You may see something like this in a general ledger. Let's take a T account for sales. You may have $100 in sales and also a reduction of $10. The difference is $90, which gets posted to the right of the T account. This is the balance. Now, I specifically picked cash and sales just to give an example of an account that has normally has a debit balance and another that normally has a credit balance. Many of you may have heard how to come up with account balances using normal account balances. If you don't know what a normal balance is for an account, you can check your accounting textbook or watch my short video. Let's take one final example of a T account. Let's say we have a loan payable, and we'll just put numbers to the left and to the right, debits and credits, and at this point, we want to know our balance. The total of our debits are $675, and our credits total $710. The difference is $35 credit that gets posted to the right. This makes sense because a loan payable normally has a credit balance. And at this point, we can take our $35 and just continue with it. And that's our new balance. And we'll post our additional transactions or whatever affects this account and come up with our new balance. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it informative. Thank you for watching.